Fentanyl is a synthetic opioid. Things like morphine and heroin are opiates that are made from the poppy plant, versus fentanyl is a synthetic made in a lab opioid that hits the opioid receptor. It's really potent, it's really strong. We use it in the hospital all the time. It's a really safe drug when used properly by doctors and nurses, but when it's really concentrated and people are using it at home, they can accidentally overdose very easily. It's a common myth that just by touching fentanyl, you can absorb it, but you really can't. And it's important that we emphasize and clarify that. It's so poorly absorbed through the skin that pharmaceutical companies actually spent millions and millions of dollars to develop something called a fentanyl patch. It's a very special way to deliver fentanyl in a patch that you wear. And even then, it's not very well absorbed. But definitely the powder or pills or anything that you find, not really absorbed through the skin. People who have an opioid toxicity, opioid overdose that ingested some fentanyl or injected fentanyl, they have minutes, maybe just moments to live. So pausing, putting on whole body suit, PPE, or waiting for other people to arrive means that person might die. So we really need to intervene and help them as quickly as possible. That might be by doing CPR. It might mean by giving the antidote, which I carry with myself all the time, Narcan, naloxone. So we have just moments to do that. And so waiting, because we're concerned about skin exposure, is not correct. Inhaling fentanyl can technically cause an overdose, but it doesn't get aerosolized very well. So fentanyl has something called a low vapor pressure. So you really can't aerosolize it without some very complex mechanism. You can play with it. You can technically throw it up in the air and have it fall, and you really won't breathe significant amounts in. So it's not really dangerous to walk in a building that has fentanyl in it. You don't need a fancy respirator or anything like that. So I told a friend of mine recently who's a paramedic about this because she was really worried about getting exposed to fentanyl. And the relief on her face when I clarified that it's not really something she needs to worry about, that she's not gonna walk into a building and touch fentanyl or breathe it in and have something bad happen to her, it was such a relief. She told her family and they were relieved. So I think it's really important that we make sure everyone understands how this works. When someone overdoses on fentanyl or another opioid, their breathing will slow. They'll eventually become unconscious and their breathing may stop altogether. And that's how it's deadly. If you find someone who's overdosed on fentanyl or another opioid, you should call 911. And if you have Narcan, naloxone, you should administer to them. The two most common ways it's administered are intranasally through the nose and then also an injection. And in California, you can get Narcan, naloxone. Anyone can get it without a prescription. Walking into a space, evaluating a person who's overdosed on fentanyl, calling 911, even doing CPR and definitely administering Narcan are all 100% safe to do.